Hello friends, welcome to this video on triangles. In the previous video, we discussed some properties of triangles. Today, we will discuss some concepts based on it. So let's start. Triangle XYZ is an isosceles triangle and sides XY and XZ are equal to each other. Choose the correct answer from the options given below. Friends, look at the first option. In this, angles X and Y are given to be equal. According to the question, triangle XYZ is an isosceles triangle. Therefore, the angles opposite to its equal sides will be equal. But look at the angles X and Y. These are not the opposite angles of the equal sides. Hence, this option is incorrect. In the second option also, it's given that angles X and Z are not opposite to the equal sides. So, these angles would also not be equal and thus this option is also incorrect. Look at the third option, which is the last option. Angles Y and Z are angles opposite to the equal sides. Therefore, these angles will be equal. So, this option is correct. Let's look at a similar question. Triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle where sides AB and AC are equal. Choose the correct option. Friends, we know that the sum of all the angles in a triangle is 180 degrees. In the figure, angle A measures 76 degrees. If we put this in the equation, then we will get the measure of the sum of angles B and C and it comes out to be 104 degrees. Hence, option 1 is the correct answer. Now look at the second option. Angle B is given to be 52 degrees. And we know that angles opposite to equal sides in an isosceles triangle are equal. By looking at the figure, we can see that angles B and C are both opposite to the equal sides and hence, they will be equal. This means we can replace angle C by angle B and this way we get the measure of angle B as 52 degrees. That is why this option is also correct. Let's look at another question. Triangle XYZ and triangle LMN are both isosceles triangles. The pair of their corresponding angles are equal. So, are these triangles congruent? Friends, these two triangles are isosceles triangles. But there is no information given about the sides of these two triangles. And it's given that a pair of their corresponding angles are equal. So the third angle will also be equal. But for two triangles to be congruent, it is necessary for at least one side to be included. In order to prove congruence, all angles being equal is not enough. And in these triangles, no information is given about the sides. That is why these two triangles are not congruent. That's it for today's session. Today we discussed some concepts related to the properties of triangles. See you in the next video. Thank you.